We introduce in another tutorial the Aladin data collections tree, and we will now demonstrate some advanced features. First of all, you can rearrange or sort the tree in different ways using the sort button located at the bottom of the panel here. So we can sort, for example, the full collection by wavelength or by year of publication to see the recent resources, or just switch back to the default sorting. The sorting can be applied to all the leaves under a given node by first selecting it, so the image branch for example, clicking on the dedicated sort button here, and for the image we'll sort by coverage, that is the fraction of the sky which is covered by each survey. There are various icons used for data collections. First, an icon describing the data provider. Some items come from CDS, some come from JAXA, IRAP, etc. And for some of them, there is an RGB icon indicating that it's a color composition as opposed to single band images. The recent resources have a dedicated icon, which is a small yellow asterisk, so I sort by date, the catalogues, and in the recent one I find the Gaia DR2, which has this small yellow asterisk. And the Gaia DR2 also has a small tick indicating that it is already loaded in the stack here. The tree can be filtered by sophisticated rules, so there are some predefined filters in the list here, but there is also a button next to it where you can create new filters. For example, if you are interested in the full list of catalogues which contain measurement of proper motion, you click here and this will filter the full collection. And these filters can be named and stored for future usage. So we will call it proper motion and save it. And now this filter appears in the list at the bottom. So I switch back to the full collection. For some data collections, the information on spatial coverage is not readily available. This is the case for the SIA images coming from his arc here. So in this case, the leaves appear in gray and they are identified with a small orange icon telling that the spatial coverage is not known. We can use the scan button at the bottom to query for spatial coverage for this collection, so either here or here. And when we do that, each leaf will be asked to see if they contain data in the current field of view of Aladin. So we see they get colored in green or orange depending on the result. We will demonstrate in the next video how to access different data products from the data collection tree. Thanks for watching.